What is the formula we arrived at? We arrived at sum of n terms of a GP in n is equal to a r to power n minus 1. Okay, let's say modulus of r is greater than 1. Right, what does this mean? This means minus 1. R is less than minus 1 or R is greater than 1. In both these cases, this will be satisfied. Clear? Modulus of R, mod R, absolute value of R is greater than 1. Clear? Bolo. Then, if N tends to infinity, that means you have a very large series, lots of terms. Don't you think R to the power n will tend towards infinity if R is greater than 1 or less than minus 1? So minus infinity plus infinity, whichever way, the magnitude mod of Rn will tend towards infinity. Yes or no? If R is greater than 1, let's say 3.5, and you are raising it to power of 10 to the power 6, isn't it a huge number, very big number? Right, so that means, so if you have an infinite series, what is an infinite series? It means when n tends to infinity, very large number of terms, large number of terms, right, with mod r greater than 1. Okay, with mod r greater than 1, then mod of r n will tend to infinity again. Is this statement clear? Clear to everyone? Is this statement clear? For an infinite series, that means what is an infinite series? N tends to infinity. Number of terms is huge. And if the common ratio is greater than 1 or less than minus 1, then the absolute value of r to the power n will tend towards infinity. Yes or no? Right? So, in infinite series, greater than r is greater than 1, the sum is infinite. Negative, positive, whichever way it is, but infinite. Infinite sum. Clear? Is it okay? But same infinite series, that means n tends to infinity, but mod r now is less than 1. What do you think r to the power n will be tending to? If now r is very less, small amount, yes. So it will tend to 0. Why? Because let's say r is equal to 0.5. Right? So as you increase the power of 0.5, r square will be 0.25. It is going down. See? Then r cube is 0.125, going down further. Correct? R to the power 4 is 0.0625, going further down. Right? R to the power 5 is 0.03125. It is going down and down and down and down and down. Right? So if R to the power very large value of n, it will always be near 0. Clear? Yes, so, yeah. So, why do you want to express it like that? Aditya, what is the point? Okay, so, understand the importance of this. So, is this clear? Whichever way you want to express, but the final thing is, r to the power n is greater, is greater, going towards 0. Is r equals to 0 actual or is it simplified? R is 0. R can never be 0. Aditya, unmute and say, I can't understand. R is not 0. First of all, we are not taking R as 0. R cannot be 0 anyways. You just learned. In a GP, R cannot be 0. Then we can't define a GP. Here, we are not talking about R to be 0. We are saying, if R is very small, then R to the power n will be tending towards 0. It's not equal to 0. Tending towards. As a very, 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 very small amount of. Yeah, it's a very small number. Okay? right? So hence I have not used this expression. I am not saying this. No, I am saying as n tends to infinity, that means n is becoming bigger and bigger, Rn becoming zero. Okay, right? Now tell me, Rn, can it ever breach the limit of zero? Can it be, you know, can it become minus 0.01 ever, however much n is? Is this possible? This will never be possible. That means what? Limiting value, that is the boundary line, limiting value of r to the power n as n tends to infinity is zero. So r to the power n is not zero. Its limit is zero. Do you get the difference? It will always be closer to zero, but it will never breach the value of zero. Do you get the point? Right? So we are not saying Rn is zero. We are saying Rn is limiting value of Rn is zero as n tends to infinity. Now, again, come back to the same equation. Sn is equal to A okay, now condition is mod R less than 1. Now, why am I using mod R? Please understand this also. So even if it is minus 0.5, let's say, raise it to 1000, don't you think it will start going towards 0 as well? Irrespective of, right? So if R is positive, let's say this is a number line, right? If R is positive, R to the power n goes towards 0 like this. If R is negative, then R to the power n goes towards 0 like that. Clear? Right? The value, as you keep on increasing the power, the value keeps on shifting like this. And if you increase it here, it keeps on shifting like that. So both ways it is going towards 0. Is that okay? Now, if you understand that part, then bolo. So what do we understand then? There is a fixed value of Rn which it cannot breach. What is that value? 0. Correct? So I am writing limit n tends to infinity. Sn will be how much? As n tends to infinity, what will be the limiting value of Sn now? So obviously Rn has a limiting value of 0. So you put A 0 minus 1 divided by R minus 1. Yes or no? So this will be simply A 1 minus R. Do you get that? Right? This is a very interesting phenomena in maths. Very, very interesting. Why it is interesting? Let's understand this by an example. So let's say you are adding this Sn 1 plus half plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 16 plus 1 by 32. So on and so forth. Yes, infinite series, right? So now this is going towards infinity. Let's say infinite terms are there, correct? So the interesting fact is, however be the number of term, this Sn converges. The word is converges. So let's try few and then tell you how, what does it mean, converges. What will be S1 below? S1 is how much? S1 is how much? Tell me S1 value. Sum of, yes. Sum of the series with only one term is 1. Very good. What is S2? S2 is 1.5. Very good. What is S3? S3 is 1.75, isn't it? Right? What is S4? 1.875. Am I right? S4 is this much? 1.875 only. Yep. And then keep on, you know, adding this. Keep on adding this. As you move forward, you will see if you find out till 100. Now see the sum here. Let me Okay, so this is a limitation of Excel. So let's say still it is not 2, but you can see as you are adding all these. Okay, let me increase the font size. Can you see that this value? Is it visible? There you go. Correct. This is 1.999999. So you keep on adding. If you keep on adding, let's say if I add also some more terms. Okay, and here also some more terms. Now let's see what happens to the sum. Sum may be 100. Here it's coming out to be 2. Correct. And what if I change 2 to 3? Dekho, if I change 3, see it becomes 1.5. See, if I keep 3, that is, what is this? The sum is 1 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 9 plus 1 by 27 plus 1 by 81 till infinite terms. What will this value be? 1.5. Right? It is converging. Converging to this as you are increasing the number. So if you see now look at this position here. Can you see this point? All of you? Sum. Can you see this thing, guys, here? So just confirm if you can see the sum here. It's sum is mentioned here. Can you see that? Just keep watching this one. So as I will move down, see the sum which is varying. 1.4938, and now see it's now, you know, nothing is happening to 4 and 9. Only the decimal places far away from the decimal point is getting impacted. Getting it? See, it will never breach the value of 1.5. Correct? What if I do it as 4? See, 1.33. So that means if you have this 1 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 16 plus 1 by 64 plus 1 by what, 256, so on and so forth. If you take it to infinite value, you'll get what? 1.33. Okay. And what if it is 5? See, 1.25. What if it is 6? So here also you will reach a, can you tell me till what value? What will be the last value of this one? If I take 100 here, see what will happen. Can you see that? Can you tell me where will it end? What is the limiting value of the sum itself? So 1000, if you take, see, can you see that? If you take, now it cannot, the error. See, no, error. So up to this number, it is coming out to be 1.0000. So hence, this limiting sum also limiting value is 1. Correct? You will never get. If you are starting with 1, obviously, if you are starting with 1 plus something, the final value, if you have 1 plus, let's say, 1 by 1 million, 1 millennium, oh, 1 million, plus 1 by this, plus 1 by this, and what will happen? Till infinity. What is this sum? This whole sum is tending towards 1. Is that okay? Clear? Interesting. This is what is called converging series. Converging series. Clear? So all, what is the, now what is the condition for converging series? So condition for converging series is, so what is the converging series? Now you got the sum. So I'm now writing S infinity. Why? Because infinite terms are there. And what was the formula we had arrived at? 1A minus A upon 1 minus R. This is the sum of a converging series. Converging series, right, with modulus of R less than 1. I hope this is clear to everyone. Follow. Is this clear? crystal clear, yes or no? So we learned, what is the summary of the previous discussion? Summary of previous discussion is Sn. So two options, finite. If it is a finite series, whatever be the value of R, Sn is a R to the power n minus 1 upon R minus 1. Correct? If infinite, right, then again two cases. If mod R is less greater than 1, then Sn will either be infinity or negative infinity, whichever. Right? Sn itself will become infinite. But if mod R is less than 1, then Sn or S infinity is a upon 1 minus 1.